It is me, Avid Marion, coming to you live and exclusive from inside the pop star rival's girl's house. I'm hiding in their laundry basket. Smell the knickers. I'm so sneaky, like a worm. You can cut me in half, but I will still survive. I think I hear Pete Waterman.
All right,
kid.
Western calls into your pants. Tits out whenever you're ready.
No, Ozzy, you big stupid rubbish. You sound nothing like Pete Waterman. We can't sell this to the press. Do it again, how I tell you.
All right, kid, wear some clothes in your pants. Tits out whenever you're ready.
Ozzy, I love you, but you are shit. He is shit.
Bo's a jam selector. That's where he is.
He's a big one, isn't he? I bought him when I was doing all right for me, son. How do? I'm Mel B, better known as Scary Spice. You bastards, you. After a busy few days promoting me book, that looks like this, I'm taking day off. So why don't you join me? Being famous, it's nice to give some back to local community. So today, I've come to a playgroup where I used to take out Phoenix to help out. So I said to Jerry, if you want a leaf band, fuck off, do one. So she did one. Are you listening, you on Abacus, telling you a story, you ignorant little shite? By the way, if you want to buy your mum and dad something nice, why don't you save up your pocket money and buy my new book? It's in shops now. You just have to look for it. I've always been a massive fan of Carol Smiley. It was her that got me into DIY. I put that shelf up myself. I don't need no bloke. I love doing it myself. Ooh, crab paste. Looking for treasure up me. Has always been a passion of mine. Hey up, I think I've struck gold. I have struck gold. Luke, it's my new book, available in shops now. You just have to look for it. Well, that's it. That was me day off. I hope you've had a good crack, like, but I'm bloody knackered now, so I'm going to have to tell you to piss off, you complete self bastards, you! Knackered, don't come into it. I'm absolutely fooked. Hey up, Luke, it's me new book.
Available at all good shops. You just have to look for it.
You know it by now, don't you?
Can be a hero, but you can't disguise your massive mole.
All right, and welcome to the Week in Hole by me, Enrique's Mole. This week, pop idol heartthrob Will Young made a shock announcement by admitting that he has his own makeup artist to cover up his hideous spots. These before and after shots show that it's money well spent. Britney Spears has found an unlikely new pal in Italian fashion victim Donatella Versace. We caught up with the pair at Donatella's recent show in Milan.
Kiss off, knobhead! You what? You can see me camel toe.
Oh, TV!
Oh, Jesus, you can as well.
Rumours that one-time murder suspect Snoop Doggy Dogg is set to appear in the Muppets Christmas special have been confirmed. Our cameras filmed this exclusive footage during rehearsals.
Well, I tried to kiss him, but it didn't turn into a prince.
And finally, Elton John is set to release a new greatest hits album in November. He had this to say.
You can shove it up your crack. Now move out of my way. Otherwise, I will bum you into next week. Move out of my way.
Well, that was the week in Hull. But remember, if you've got a mole, don't worry. It could be worse. You could be Ulrika Johnson. She's got a chest full of moles. And if you join them together, they make the shape of a white rhino, which is particularly rare. Are we, Enrique? Let's calm down the tool.
Hello and welcome to Showbiz Chat Up a Tree on Hampstead Heath with me, the Bear. Today's guest gave us that little bit extra on Pop Idol's action. It's Kate Thornton from the telly! Da-da! You did Don't Try This at Home, didn't you?
I did, yes.
I was just wondering, it's called Don't Try This at Home, but many of the things you can't try at home unless you're rich and you own a helicopter and have a Grand Canyon in your back garden.
That's right.
I think it should be Don't Try Drugs at Home. Don't try glue sniffing at home. Is there things that you shouldn't try at home that you could try at home? Don't try and set your family on fire. Okay, what I've done, I've composed a list on a piece of paper of things that I want to know if you would try at home.
Okay.
On that little list there on the coffee table, if you just pass me it. Don't read it!
Okay.
Just have a little look. Okay.
Got it?
Okay. At home, would you eat loads of cake?
Yeah.
Would you have a party when your parents have gone away on holiday to Scarborough? Oh, look, it's Stephen! Oh, piss off, you fucking monkey idiot! Go away! You crap bastard! You know what he said? He wanted to know if you've ever got naked at home and got in front of the mirror and tried to shave your tuppence. Do you know what tuppence is?
Yeah, that used to be my nickname.
Tuppence?
Katie Tuppence, yes.
You had a nickname named after a Quim! Kate Quim! Okay, enough talk about your tuppence. Let's talk about Pop Idol. When you interviewed Gareth Gates,
yeah,
were you slightly embarrassed?
No, not at all.
I feel for him. I used to have a speech impediment myself.
Really?
Yes. I used to shout out swear words. Fuck off! Fuck off, big nose! Fuck off! Here it comes! The only way I can stop myself is if I think of sexy ladies in the shower. Fuck off! Fuck off! You in the shower! You in the shower! You!
Oh,
oh no! My tail's popped out! Get down! Christine Hamilton in the shower! Christine Hamilton in the shower! Christine Hamilton in the shower! It's getting bigger! Oh! Oh, I'm terribly embarrassed. Why does it always pop out?
Hi, I'm Michael Jackson, and welcome to Michael Jackass.
Today, motherfucker, I'm cooking an omelette for my tea. That's right, Bubbles. So without further ado, let's do the do. You like a tiny bit of mushroom in your omelette. Mmm, look at that sweet bitch eating a mushroom. You say potato, I say potato. Motherfucker, who gives a shit? This is getting on. You got sticking some eggs, but that is the main reason for... See, there's a little bit off the egg.
I do.
Got a lot of shit coming out of my nose right now. I think I might have a little bit more for you. Ain't so bad. Ain't so bad. Get the bitch a spoon. Shove that shit in your mouth. Mmm, how that tastes. That's a strong omelet. I'm a bad, invincible, omelet-making motherfucker, Jack.
October 2002. David Blaine stood for 3 days and three nights in a six-ton block of ice in London, England's Trafalgar Square. Here you will see behind-the-scenes footage of the real story.
And the thing about this challenge was that it actually became a self-imposed torture, like sharing a flat with David Copperfield, or those two queens that do the tricks with albino tigers, Siegfried and Roy. But the most worrying thing was that I had the bad feeling the extreme cold would reduce the size of my penis.
Day one in the ice block. David has been in the ice block for 3 hours and 26 minutes and is starting to feel the big chill.
As I stood in the frozen tomb, I started wondering what the fuck I was doing there. Then I remembered the whole point of this lousy trick, to get laid. Magic equals women. That's what it equals. At the end of the first day, I started to get real horny. I was surrounded by a lot of fine females, so I started to make out I was checking my pockets for loose change, when really, I was having a quick game of pocket hockey. I had no access to tissues, so my Calvins were gonna get hot and sticky. It was a good job I was in ice. That's where I was. I was in ice, yeah.
Avid's art. Here I've drawn a picture of myself celebrating with the lovely Robbie Williams because he get the £80 million record deal. Hurrah! We are getting so drunk, we have decided to be kinky. Look at each of us. Oh, but where is his flatmate, Jonathan Wilkes? He is right behind him like he always is, coming out of the crack, dressed as the Rocky Horror. Oh, I like Jonathan Wilkes. Well, if Robbie was your friend, wouldn't you try to carve a career out of it? Jonathan Wilkes is rubbish. I like him.
The first rule of being a pop princess is being liked. If I was called to turn up at a premiere or perform at a concert, and all my fans were there asking me to sign their autograph books and to speak to their families on their mobile phones, I don't think I could do that. In fact, I know I couldn't. I'd be like that. Probably both of them. Is that it? Right, thanks for beer. Off to the pub. Anyone coming? Ah, oh, you're still filming, so you're not going to answer. Okay. Right.
See you then. Bow Selecta.
I only use it to export, never to import. Hello to you. Today, I am lucky enough to be joined by Honor Blackman's daughter, Mariella Fostrop. When you have made love, do you clean your fangita straight away, or do you love the musky smell?
What are you doing? I had the most realistic dream that I had a talk show and Mariella Fostrop was my guest. And I am covered in sex wee. I think I better go wash.
I'd love to lick your honey pot.
Quite rude, wasn't it?
Rico, Craig, David here in my hometown. That's right, I've come back to Leeds to see the wankers I hung about with and the mum that dragged me up. That's right, Kez, there's going to be some proper drama. When I say Bo, say Selecta. Bo! Selecta!
Hello?
It's Craig David. Hello, Mum.
Mum, what are you doing?
I'm looking for that tape where you were in school play when you were little.
Oh, don't put that on, Mum.
Why?
It's embarrassing.
Oh, you won't.
Every time I come round, she puts school play videos on.
My name's Jesus. Check it out. All week. I'm king of Jews. A lot of banks. Tall gold. Donkeys. Frankincense.
The size of me chin. It's fucking massive. While I'm home, my mum says that I better go see my brother. We don't get on, really, on two accounts. One, we've both got different dads. Two, he's jealous of me because I'm a pop star. Oh, and three, he's jealous of me peregrine falcon. All he can afford is a couple of pigeons.
You jealous? You stroke her if you want. Stroke her? No, you can't. Nobody can. Go on, stroke her. No, you can't. I'm gonna wind you up. Here, stroke her.
No, you're right.
No, you can stroke her, honestly. Stroke her? No, you can't.
Look at it, Kez. It were here when I first started DJing. This place to me is like having what at Beatles. Come on, Kez, let's have a go at record players. Calm down, Kez. You can't have a go. You'll scratch records with your beak. She will, you know.
I played it on a Monday, I played it on a Tuesday, I played it on a Wednesday, and a Thursday, and a Friday, and a Saturday, but not on Sunday, because I was fucking knackered. Yes, you bastard! What did I tell you? You're going to scratch record! She has as well, the scratches all over it. Post and lecture! It's nice to be back home. Get to see lads and that, you know. Have a drink with them. Like old times. I hope it's going to be like old times. All right, lads? Craig David would like a pint of lager and a pack of water. Yes, please. Thanks a lot.
You're still wearing that piss bag that they gave you?
Yeah, well, I have to, you know, but sometimes forget to put it on like.
He got them pissed himself.
Oh, shut up, you. You're only jealous because I'm a pop star. I've met Eddie Lennox. Bastards. Come on, Tess, we don't need them. Well, that were Leeds. Some things don't change, but I have. I used to be just Craig David from Molly in Leeds, but now I'm Craig David, UK garage sensation, and I'm proper bow. Come on, Tess. Stop calling her that. She's not a slag. She's me mum. Post Selecta.
Do you like my new body? Do you want a new body like my new body? I've got a body. It's my body.
Apart from Cat Daly, this Fame Academy is rubbish, right?
Yeah.
How about I put one of my home videos on?
Okay.
What about this one when I meet Patsy Palmer? No, she was a cow. Oh, the Barbara Windsor, right?
Yeah, my favorite.
You like this one? I look slightly different. I have a tash.
Can you put two Avid, please?
Yes, will you spell it for me, darling?
A-V-I-D.
Oh, that's easy enough, isn't it?
I want to make you understand that I love you.
Oh,
if I can kiss on your cheek.
Yeah, okay.
Okay. Okay. I just check to see this way. Is it working?
It's working.
But I've got to make you understand, yeah. I love you.
Oh, that's very kind.
Can I kiss you?
Yeah, of course, of course.
Is it on?
Okay.
I am very
okay.
happy.
All right, sweetie. Take care.
Have it? What the hell are you doing?
Yeah, I have a really itchy crotch. I think we might have termites. I've got to wipe them up with a tissue.
Bloody termites.
Hello, Gareth. Welcome to Celebrity Test, the computer interview. There are 9 categories of questions for you to choose from. Please select a category by simply touching the screen. Please choose any number. Could you please hurry up? Number 2. Describe your ideal partner. Thank you for doing Celebrity Test.
Van Jeter.
Check this shit. I'm Michael Jackson, and this is moonwalking. Hee-hee. Shall moon.
Oh, Mr. Moonwalk.
I'm just checking my best off on a moonwalk right now. Shall moon, brothers. You want to check my body? Shall moon mofo. Hee-hee. You're looking to be with desire. That's what you said, right? What a fine day for a moonwalk. Shall moon. Oh, God damn, Neil, split my pants then. Shit, that brother hasn't even got no pants on. Some of the time, the police don't like it when you do moonwalking. Especially if you're looking as bad and invincible as I do. Shit, moon brother.
Oh, yeah, David Blaine, frozen in time.
day two in the ice block.
As I stood there freezing my bollocks off, I became aware that people around me could see me, but they couldn't hear me. So to pass the time and amuse myself, I started to hurl abuse at them.
Hey, fat bitch! You go on a diet! Hey, dickhead! Your mother's a whore! I fucked all your women! How old are you? You must be 49, still a virgin, right?
Yeah, it was kind of fun.
I think David's a pretty crazy guy. He can get any woman he wants just by using his magic.
I think it's amazing. He's king of the world. But I don't think he realizes that the cold will reduce his penis to the size of a hamster's penis. I don't think he realizes that. Why would he do it?
Day three, David's last day in the ice block.
As my challenge was nearing its end, I started to lose my mind. I felt my penis size reducing minute by minute. All I kept thinking of was women laughing at me. Slowly slipping in and out of consciousness, I was nearly there. I could feel the melting ice around me. I'd spent almost 3 days trapped in an icebox, a mental and physical challenge that I would have got away with if it wasn't for those meddling kids. Not only was I a failure, I was a failure with a really tiny penis. Jesse.
Well, drink a card, huh? Drink it hard, drink with your card, right? Yeah. I'm not such a failure. Sit down.
Dear God, thank you, please, for letting me meet all the lovely celebrities. I love you.
Maybe so many. Look, I really think it's time you let me go now. And stop following all these celebrities. Get yourself a life. You're going to get yourself into trouble.
You know what, Greg? Maybe you are right. Maybe I should stop following the celebrities. I have my memories, right?
Mm, of course.
I have the memories. Memories.
Memories you gave of me. Sweet, sweet. Memories you gave of me. You got me. The memories you gave of me.
Take one fresh and tender kiss.
You got me. The memories you gave of me.
Add one stolen night of bliss.
You got me. The memories you gave of me.
One girl.
What, Craig? What? I don't think I can stop following the celebrities. What? I fucking love them. Come on, Craig. Let's take a shower.